scientists have just spotted gravitational waves from the Big Bang. But what are these waves, and why should we care about them? Here are five things you should know. I'm Sophie, and welcome to The Countdown. If you've been following the news, you may have heard about BICEP 2. This stands for Background Imaging of Cosmic Extragalactic Polarization 2, a telescope located in Antarctica. BICEP 2 uses 512 radio wave detectors to observe the cosmic microwave background, or CMB, which is the light left over from the Big Bang. At the South Pole, BICEP 2 and its sister detector, the Keck Array, can avoid noise that might disturb the CMB's signal. The air is thin and dry, which makes it easier to detect microwaves. And without a large human population, there are no competing signals from cell phones or televisions. BICEP 2 wasn't just looking at the CMB, it was measuring the orientation of the CMB's photons. Specifically, it was looking for a particular kind of curl in the light called B-mode polarization. By mapping the polarization of the cosmic microwave background over an area of the sky, researchers found a signature left behind by gravitational waves. So, what are gravitational waves? According to Einstein, our universe is made up of a fabric called space-time. Heavy objects deform space-time, creating a curve that funnels smaller bodies towards the bigger ones. This is how gravity works. But the deformation caused by the larger object doesn't stay put. It can travel through the fabric of space-time like a wave traveling down a string. These ripples are called gravitational waves, and they zip through space-time at the speed of light. The ripples can be produced when large objects accelerate quickly, like when two black holes spiral towards each other. But the gravitational waves detected by BICEP 2 come from the time immediately after the Big Bang, and they prove that an event called inflation really occurred. With the Big Bang, our universe began expanding. A slow, even expansion would have created a universe with an uneven distribution of density and temperature. But our universe is relatively even. So in 1981, Alan Guth proposed the expansion must have accelerated almost immediately after the Big Bang. This theoretical speed-up, called inflation, would explain the smooth universe we see today. And it would also have produced gravitational waves strong enough to impact the cosmic microwave background. You can see how BICEP 2's discovery is a big deal. It reveals the presence of gravitational waves and proves the theory of inflation. Oh, and it also hints at the existence of a multiverse. Inflation predicts the same forces that made space expand super quickly also created pocket universes within our own. In fact, infinite pocket universes, giving us a multiverse, which means that somewhere out there, there might be exact copies of our galaxy and our planet and you. I'm Sophie Bushwick, and that's your countdown. For more spacey stuff, subscribe to the Space Lab channel on YouTube or follow us on Twitter at @SA_SpaceLab. And if you've got any topics you'd like to see in the future, let us know in the comments.
So Sophie, how do we know that there is some universe out there that could be a duplicate, exact duplicate of our own?
Well, there's an infinite number of universes, right? So there's a probability greater than zero that at least one of those universes is identical to ours. In fact, there is the possibility that there's infinite universes that are identical to ours and that have identical people running around identical Earths. So there could be universes out there where I'm not a science writer. Or there could be universes out there where this YouTube channel has a billion subscribers, and so on and so forth.
God.